weird is that? Vintage. I'm ready. Call Tyler Perry. Call him. Call Mr. Perry and tell him I'm ready. Wig ready. Makeup ready. Somebody call Tyler and tell him I'm ready. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am bringing you guys a vintage look. It's my take on a retro pinup style based in the 1950s. I'm going in with my e.l.f. skincare, something I swear by because it is affordable. You can find it in stores, mainly at Target is where I get mine, and it's very hydrating and my skin takes to it very well. I just applied the toner and I'm just fanning it out now so it dries down a little bit before I go in with the next product. Here I'm using the Daily Moisturizer and I'm just going to put it all around my face and work it into the skin. I do have combination skin, so after this Daily Moisturizer, I will be going in with a extra hydrating. This is going to give me a good foundation and it's going to be able to protect my skin from dryness from the full coverage look that I will be putting on today. All items used in this video will be listed down below in the description bar. So please, if you have any questions, go ahead and look to see all the products that I use to achieve the final looks and results located at the end of this video. I always take my time while I work these moisturizing products into my skin. I did speed this video up for the sake of time purposes, but I'm making sure that I'm being extra delicate and taking my time and treating my skin with love and care. Milk of Magnesia just happens to be a primer of choice for me. It works really well for my skin. And as you see, I'm just spreading this out over my face. I am not necessarily mixing it in to my moisturized base. I'm just smoothing it out and I'll be drying it down. Next, I'm going to get these eyebrows together. I'll be bringing you guys a specific eyebrow tutorial at a later time, but I'm just working this pomade into my brows. I've been microbladed probably 3 times now, and I have really fine eyebrow hairs, some of which are non-existent. So I'm just going in with that pomade and bringing it up to a higher arch and making sure my brows get as close as symmetrical as possible. I learned to draw my eyebrows freehanded from Lyric the makeup artist here on YouTube. She has some really good videos and I was studying her way back when, probably in 2012, and this is where I learned my technique on how to free draw brows and clean them up. They don't have to be perfect, but make sure when you go in to conceal your brows, you try to make sure that you can match them up symmetrically and you just make everything look nice, neat, and try to make them look as natural as possible if that's the look you're going for. After I work on my eyebrows, I then conceal my eyelids and blend that concealer into the lids. I like the process of using a brush now more than a beauty blender. I don't know. I just like working with the brush, and it allows me to push the product into the skin. And yeah. It's just a method I've just been enjoying as of lately, and I get it up underneath the eye. You see me pulling my nose to the side just because I try to leave my features as natural as possible. Here on this channel, you'll never see me doing any kind of nose contour or anything like that. I'll probably just go in with a highlight, but I like to leave things, you know, unique and as individual as I am, I want my looks to kind of remain the same, even though I am putting on makeup, without transforming myself too much. Next, I just work my Black Radiance makeup sticks into the skin. I love this kabuki brush. It allows me to get like a flawless finish, and I'm just pushing the product into the skin, and kind of it's giving me that perfect melt that I'm looking for that makes my skin look natural. I do blend the two colors together to get a perfect match. Sometimes I have a hard time finding foundation product because I fall in a deeper category, but my undertones still remain kind of golden and red at the same time. I absolutely love this Kiss BB cream. This was the first style of foundation that I ever used way back in the day when I first started, and it just works so well in the skin. And even on the days where you don't want to do a lot of makeup, you just throw this BB cream on and it just gives you the ultimate glow and makes your skin look so refreshed. Now I'm just going in with my concealer. I'm so glad I found this concealer, and this is just how I go in to highlight. Normally you would let these dry down a little bit just because it'll give you a full coverage look. But because I'm going through with a soft glam retro style look, I just take my time and blend this out with my brush. And again, you can choose to use a beauty blender to go through and complete this process. But I just like stamping that concealer in with that brush, and also going back in and revisiting the eyelid just to make sure everything is covered and everything is blended correctly. I also like to use my natural facial structure and cheekbones as a guide on how far I choose to pull out that highlight. And because I did go in with the mix of those foundations, there's no need for me to contour because my face and the way the light shines just naturally creates it for me. I still love my Benai Topaz powder, and I mix that in with my Derma blend. I use this more orangey tone just because it reflects my deep skin tone a little bit better, as you can see. Also, make sure when you guys are applying these powders, I'm using a brush. Just push it into the skin and make sure everything is kind of sitting evenly and there's no spots or gaps in your base. I just use a fine dust of powder. I'm not baking just because that's not the look that I'm going for in this style of makeup. Then I'm going to use my Juvia's Place palette. I'm not even sure of the name of this one, but I think it's the first, probably one of the first ones that they created. And I'm just using that brownish reddish tone to build out a little bit of shadow on my lid that still take on a natural look, but it's just going to give me a little bit of depth to help out with this retro look and give that liner that I will be applying just something to sit on. I'm going to add in just a little bit of that yellow soft banana color from a traditional palette that I got from my local beauty supply store, just to help give me a little bit of pop at the end. Now I'm just using a clean powder brush to dust off all that excess powder. Now I'm going in with a flesh tone powder to just kind of blend everything together, especially working it in those sides of the face that kind of mirror a semi-natural kind of contour and flesh out all that extra brightness that the powder applied. I'm just going to dust a little bit of brown over that so it's not too much. Now for blush. I have no idea where this palette came from, But I do like to use the orange and that light maroon color to give me my desired look. I do my blush somewhat like this on a traditional day-to-day, just not as much. But I think this in itself brings this whole retro soft glam look together, followed by a little highlight. You see me going in the bridge of my nose and my cubic bow just to give me some pop. We're gonna waterline and tightline with one of these jumbo pencils from the hair store as well, just helping to bring everything along. I believe this one is in a black brownish color. I did my liner offline just because I'm a little shaky, but you see a little cat wing, something very small. I'm going in with these individual lashes. I got them from Amazon, and I'm just gonna focus on the end of my eye, just building up a little volume. Now, just going in with that dermal blend powder on that big brush and just pushing it into the skin. Over everything that I have applied, I'm just pushing a light layer right on in. I use my Ruby Kisses Choco Craze as a liner. I swear by this stuff. Every time I see it, I buy it up in bulk just because it's just something that's a staple in my makeup kit. Add a couple moles. I'm trying to place them where my moles and natural freckles apply in my skin, if I can see them through this very soft glam makeup foundation. The three moles on the side is one of my signatures, so something I do. Next is Oh Boy, I believe that's the name of that lippy, also Ruby Kisses, and other pinky mauvey lip gloss. I'm blending it in between my finger, the brush, and I'm just applying those two colors back to back until I get the desired natural look for my skin. The brush is helping me pat that matte look right on in and trying to make this as natural as possible. I really like how this look turned out, especially with this being matte liquid lipsticks. I think this is gonna be a go-to lip look for me. And it looks really nice and really natural. What do y'all think?
Get my wig.
Y'all have to excuse the Clifford in the background. It's keeping Scion busy while I finish this look.
I be having so much fun by myself. Look at these cheekbones. I can't wait to show y'all a picture of Scion when he was little. Well, he's still little, but when he was a baby, a couple months, I took him to go take pictures and that's it. All right, this is a wig that I've had for a while. I boiled it and cut her up last night.
Just applying that excess makeup to the lace of this wig. I'm only using it for the sake of these photos, so I won't be gluing this down or putting this wig down any kind of way. It's just getting slapped up there and it's gonna sit there like that. Sometimes these synthetic T-parts can be a pain in the butt, especially when you're trying to customize these wigs to look a certain type of way. But I worked with what the best that I had to get the result that I needed. especially seeing how your girl's always running late to something. So I was running late to my pictures anyway, so I had to just get her together the best way I knew how. And I think she looks good. Like, I'm getting into character.
We are dream girls. Sitting on my head and just sitting up. And you, y'all gonna love me.
Jennifer, who? If I honestly got me a little voice coach or something, I could do a little something.
I'm saying, it's supposed to look like a wig. Bitch, didn't everybody wear wigs back in the day? Yeah. I didn't even know baby has any. Because it's supposed to look like a wig. It's supposed to look slapped on. It's supposed to look. And y'all going to love me.
Let's not forget the silk scarf. That's just gonna help lay everything down. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I hope y'all enjoy my look. Like, comment, and subscribe.
Any small opportunity for enjoyment that I get, I take it, because that's the only life for me.